Good morning. How about a botany or microbiology lesson today? Way back in 1983, I inherited a plot of land from my mom and dad. It was in Kenton-on-Sea, where Jeanette and I now live. I was thrilled to see that the plot had quite a few milkwood trees. Now, I have a love of milkwood trees. They remind me of my childhood days, climbing in them like Tarzan, lying in their shade, and oh, the smell of their flowers always brought back to me those wonderful holidays at Kenton or Kasuka. However, I discovered Jeanette cannot stand them. She detests the sickly sweet scent of the flowers, and even more so when people tramp the little purple berries onto our floor or carpets. Milkwood trees are protected trees. You may not destroy them or even cut off a branch without a permit. So when on close inspection, I found that many of the tree's leaves were infected with these horrible little nodules. I tried to find out what I should do to spray them with and to try and save my milkwood trees. It was then that I learned that these myriads of nodules were not a disease, but actually millions of little nitrogen-fixing bacteria which absorb nitrogen from the air, which is 80% nitrogen, and convert it to nitrates, which are essential for all plant growth. Then, when the leaves eventually die and fall to the ground, they supply nitrates to the undercover. You see, these milkwood trees grow on ancient sand dunes, notoriously low in nitrate. So God, in his wisdom, gave these little bacteria to the milkweeds to help them to grow. And then when the leaves fall off to supply everything growing underneath with nitrates. This is why milkweeds are protected, not because they are scarce, there are thousands of them growing along our extensive coastline, but because these milkweeds supply nitrates to an otherwise barren sandy soil. Now, I believe there was an important lesson for me here, and I hope for you too. Not everything that looks terrible or threatening is so. It can be for our benefit or even for our survival. So the discipline we received as children from parents or school has been of immense value, even though we didn't like it at the time. Often I have prayed to God for something that I was sure was the right thing for me, only to find God saying, "No, I have other plans for you." Needless to say, at the time I was most upset. But now, in retrospect, I can see that God was so right, and I am so glad of it. God's plan has turned out to be a blessing. Let us pray. Father God, we know that you have a perfect plan for each and every one of us. Help us to follow that plan, no matter what our circumstances are right now. May we discover that you will indeed bring good out of it for us, for our church, for our country, our world. We do believe that all things can work together for good when we cooperate with you in love, even out of this COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdown in which we find ourselves. We pray that despite everything, in fact, because of everything, our world may become a better place. Your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Amen. Go now in love and peace and expect God to do great things in your life.